one of the questions we get all the time is like, is there a dose response for ketones? Is there an upper limit for ketones? What happens if you take too much?
So single dose exogenous ketones will typically raise beta-hydroxybutyrate levels within about 15 to 20 minutes, and they'll tend to stay elevated for up to 2 hours. Depending on the dose, it can get you into a level of ketosis that can definitely have metabolic effects that could potentially enhance performance. So there's probably an optimal range for BHB concentrations when it comes to things like enhancing recovery or improving performance. They remain to be fully established, but I think the evidence is there that you would have to get to a certain threshold in order to be able to exert some of the potential benefits of exogenous ketones. Because people are very individual in terms of the response to any form of intervention, and including the supplementation with ketones, there may be some value in being able to measure that for different individuals. So that would allow them to maybe take very specific amounts to achieve the concentration that is needed and that's specific to them.
What limits people is often their ability to use ketones. So there are people, they can't use glucose very well at all, right? So ketones is a much better fuel for them. But we've also found that to overcome things like this, you should use exercise. So the more exercise, the more movement that you get, the more your cells can actually use ketones. So that's why what we always say, you know, myself, Dr. Ryan Lowry, basically, is that ideally the first thing that you should do is take ketones, right? A lot of people are not very well conditioned. So when they do a ketogenic diet, they can't make ketones very well, okay? So you can overcome that by taking ketones. Once you start doing that and you can use them better, then we recommend going on a ketogenic diet, and then to optimize it, do exercise, because that improves ketone uptake.
What we know from looking at rodent studies that have been done, that have looked at training, they've been able to show that in muscle, after a period of training, these rodents are better able to uptake and utilize ketones. So there's definitely something going on in the periphery in terms of the use of ketones. There's no doubt they can be used.